بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We praise Him and we ask the help from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide him, and whomever misguided, no one will guide him. I bear witness and I believe there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty. And Muhammad is the last and final messenger. Hayatul Sahaba, the life of Sahaba radiyallahu anhum. The life of Sahaba radiyallahu anhum. May Allah please with them, those companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If somebody asks you, go and try to find a beautiful flower among of so many kind of flowers, you will find so difficult to choose. But if somebody asks you, go and choose a flower in a place where is drought and there is no any flower, it's very easy to find and pick up this flower. And this is how the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of them, they wrote amazing history. They were amazing generation. They graduate not from university of such so and so, but they graduate from the best university, the university of the humanity, the university of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They graduate from the school of Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Abd al-Muttalib صلى الله وسلم عليه أجمعين. Today inshallah we're going to talk about wallahi, when I read her story, my heart shaking. It's unnormal. I thought I'm reading a story of Mujahid, great man, warrior, strong heart, but not. I was reading about a woman, amazing woman. Wallahi, I put my head down. This woman, she was amazing sabira, patience, sabr. This woman, she faced amazing and huge difficulty with her family, because her father was number one enemy of Islam. And her father has a powerful words, because he was among of the leaders of Quraysh. This woman, the only woman, she married with the greatest man who walked over this earth. This woman, the only woman she married with the greatest man walking over this earth from far away. This woman, she was the closest related or relative to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Without any further delay, who is she is? Ramlah bint Sufyan radiyallahu anha wa ardaha. Ummu Habiba. Ummu Habiba radiyallahu anha wa ardaha. Ramla bintu Abi Sufyan bintu Harb. Sufyan ibn Harb, the leader of Quraysh. Ummu Habiba. Ummu Habiba radiyallahu anha, she was among of the people of Quraysh as a normal people. And she was the daughter of the leader of Quraysh. She's from high state, from wealthy family, from strong tribes, tribes of Umayyah. What she wants, she can get. Wealth, states, high class, family, strong tribes, protected, powerful. So with all this fitna, that would does not stopped her to search for truth and declare and say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and believe in the message of Islam, and she become a Muslim. Ramla bint Abi Sufyan, she married with a person, his name Ubaidullah. And that Ubaidullah, he also become a Muslim. Now, she become Muslim and her husband become a Muslim. She faced very high difficulty because her husband, her father, Sufyanu ibn Harb, was among of the leader of Quraysh, a number one enemy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What was he doing all the way to destroy Islam? So his own daughter become a Muslim. Oh my God, I'm fighting Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and fighting and hitting and trying, punishing and trying, demolishing Islam. Then his own daughter become a Muslim. Can you imagine this daughter? How many times she thought, when I want to declare Islam, I'm going to face this difficulty, my family, my tribes, the enemies. With all this, this not stopped her to declare Shahada to Allah, ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. As she is among of the Muslims, she faced so much difficulty. She been tortured. So what's the decision now? They listen to the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the weak people who been tortured. Nabi sallallahu alaihi ordered them to migrate. Which country we should migrate? We only knew Sham and Yemen. But Sham and Yemen, they are not Muslims, and they will be in dangerous situation if they go. Where are we going? Nabi sallallahu guided them, go to Malikul Habasha, the king of Abyssinia. He was very well known. He was well known justice king, or king who rule the country with justice. So they went, and she migrated to Abyssinia, radiallahu anha wa ardaha. She is now far away from her city. She is in new places where she doesn't have people, she know them. And only her husband with her as a related. So subhanallah, she remained there with the Islam. Suddenly, she faced another hard situation or hard or difficulty. That one time she slept and she saw bad dreams. What is that bad dream? She saw her husband, Ubaidullah, in bad situation or evil situation. What's wrong? When she woke up, she told her husband, I saw you in the bad situation or bad way. So he ignored and he abandoned and he doesn't, you know, give any attention to the dream, the one she saw. Then afterwards, he told her, I want to change my religion to return to Christianity. Allahu Akbar. He want to follow the religion of the people of Al-Habasha, the people of Abyssinia. They were Christian. And he told her, before Islam, I'm more like Christianity. Then the Islam come, I become a Muslim. And now I want to come back to the Christianity. And she advised him as a husband, I saw you in bad states. How come? What is the evidence? You change from the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Tawheed, to the Trinity or the Aqidah, which doesn't have any evidence. She advises him, but he ignored and he did not listen. And from that moment, he started drinking alcohol and become alcoholic, addicted. And after a while, he died from alcoholic. Can you imagine? Now, she is in a strange country as a stranger, in Abyssinia. Her husband, the one he used to protect her, he died in the bad situation, and she remained alone, lonely, with her Islam. Can you imagine the pressure in non-Muslim country or in non-Muslim city? Alone, far away from her family, far away from her relative, with all this pressure. Allahu Akbar, Ummu Habiba, Ramla bint Sufyan, she decided to remain in her house and close her house and run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with her dua. And in that time, she delivered a baby and she named her Habiba. Named her Habiba, and she has from that time, everybody call her Ummu Habiba. Ummu Habiba. Habib or Habiba, the lover one, in Arabic meaning. So she has a very cute daughter name. Very cute name for her daughter, Ummu Habiba radiyallahu anha. Ummu Habiba radiyallahu anha, she remained in her home, calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give her an iman and give her strength in her faith and her iman, and help her in her situation. She is lonely, no husband. Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar. The faraj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the opening of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to this woman. That shocking news. Shocking, really shocking. She dreamed, as she mentioned, I dreamed that a call came to her, named her, O Umm al-Mu'mineen. O Ummu al-Mu'mineen. O Ummu al-Mu'mineen mean O the mother of the believers. Subhanallah, she interpreted her dream as, inshallah, she will be one of the wife of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. After she saw the dream, a lady, she was a servant and slave for the king of Najashi. She knocked the door. She opened. Who? She said, Abshiri, is a good news that the king of Abyssinia informed you that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent a letter, he requesting that to marry you. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is, she wasn't in Mecca. She's far away. And how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remembered me? Allahu Akbar, I'm in the strange place. Even Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not see her at that time, she's far away. Allahu Akbar. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked her hand. So the king of Abyssinia and Najashi, he called all the Muslims, come. And who was the speaker person, or the one he speak on the behalf of Muslims? Ja'far ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu. Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, the uncle of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was there. So the king of Abyssinia, he said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent me a letter that he asking the hand of Ummu Habiba. So is any wakil like somebody on behalf? So they appointed her relative Khalid, his name Khalid. He related to her, he was Muslim, and he appointed as a wakil to her. Then the Najashi, he said, the sidaq, the mahar, the diary of the marriage, I will pay on behalf of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he paid her 400 dinars. And among of the wives of Rasulullah, she is the most highest diary, radiallahu anha. And he paid, and after he paid, and Ja'far, Khalid, the one he related as a wakil, he accepted the offer of Rasulullah that he marry her. And after the marriage, they want to go back. Then the Najashi told them, remain, because the sunnah of Al-Anbiya, the sunnah of the prophets and messengers, after they marry, they will celebrate with the food. Then he ordered for the food to be brought it, and all the Sahaba radiallahu anhum was there. They eat and they celebrate with the marriage of Umm Habiba Ramla bin Atu Abi Sufyan radiallahu anha wa ardaha. And everybody come to her, visit her, congratulate her with the good news that she is now the wife of the best man, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, out of the happiness, Umm Habiba, out of happiness, you know what she did? When she heard the news from the servant and slave, she took two bracelets made out silver, and she gave to the servant, the one she brought her the news, that Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asking her hand. Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah. From the darkness of the stranger, she was a stranger, the darkness of worriness, the situations, it's all, if any other woman, she said, all the life surrounded me by darkness, all the ways closed. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed that mu'mina, the true believer, the opening of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After a period of time, when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam migrated to Medina, he sent a person to bring all the Sahaba from Abyssinia to Al-Madina. And in the time of 7 the Hijrah, the year of 7 of migration of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they call Fathu Khaybar, Ja'far bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, and all the Sahaba, and with them Umm Habiba, Ramla bint Abi Sufyan, all of them came to Al-Madina. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I don't know in which one I will be happy, opening of Khaybar or coming of Ja'far bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, and the group with them. And Umm Habiba, subhanAllah, she already arrived, and she is the wife of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Her place is ready for her, waiting for her, and she, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, loved her so much, and radiallahu anha, she came to Medina with honor and state. Umm Habiba radiallahu anha, Ramla bint Abi Sufyan, she was very kind and great wife. She did not, subhanAllah, argue with other wives, because she is from high class family. So I will not argue with other women. She kept herself in high state. Not argue, not make any issues. Radiallahu anha. Umm Habiba also, she show al-wala wal-bara. My heart belongs to Islam. My soul belongs to Islam. My love belongs to Islam. Although that her husband, radiallahu anhu, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fighting the biggest enemy, who? Her father. Battle Badr, Battle Uhud, Battle Al-Khandaq, all this battlefield, fighting between the father and the husband. And she did not put her down. My father, how come fighting? She remained her heart to Islam. And wallahi, it's not easy. But here the test, the trial. And I will tell you the one story showing how much her heart belonged to Allah and Rasulullah. Even, subhanAllah, her father, non-Muslim, no. Although you are my father, all right. But you are the enemy of Islam. I will not show my wala and bara to you. Sufyan ibn Harb, her father, when before Fath Makkah, before opening of Makkah, and they put the Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, the pledge and the peace, in the Hudaybiyah time. One of the ruling, any tribes would like to be with the Muslims, they have the right. And any tribes would like to be with a kuffar, they have the right. So the tribes of Bani Bakr, okay, the tribes of Bani Bakr, they went with Quraysh. And the tribes of Bani Khuza'a, they choose the Muslims. Here, both of them shouldn't fight each other. But Bani Bakr, being supported by the kuffar of Quraysh, they went and they killed people from the people of Bani Khuza'a. And Amr ibn Salim, he went all the way to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he said a poem. He said, "Hum bayatuna wa qataluna ruk'an wa sujjada." Yani they led us in the night and they came while we are praying and they killed us. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he heard that news, أعوذ بالله, they kill innocent people, he cannot handle, he said, "Nusirta ya Amr ibn Salim. You will be inshallah victorious, O Abdullah bin Abi Salim, the leader of Bani Khuza'a." The Nabi ﷺ want to support them because those enemies, they broke the pledge. What happened after that? Sufyan ibn Harb, he's scared that some situation happened. He went all the way to Medina to renew the pledge. Make sure everything alright. We don't want to fight again. We are not ready. So he went all the way to Medina. He asked for any shafi'. Shafi' means intercession. Somebody like, please don't disturb or don't harm Sufyan, because Sufyan ibn Harb, he's an enemy of Islam. He involved killing some Muslims. So he went trying, everybody reject. So he said, "I should go to my daughter, Habiba." He went to her to ask about her house, and he went all the way there. And she opened the house and she welcomed him. He went to sit down on one mattress or some place for sitting. So when he went to sit down, she take it out. Oh, he's surprised, what's wrong? "Do you like the mattress? Yani is too much for me to give it to me?" So he replied to her, "Araghibti bihi anni?" So what's happened? She said, she replied back, "This is the firash, this is the mattress, this is the bed of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and you are impure, you are unclean, you are najis, you are unclean, and you are mushrik. You're committing shirk, you're worshipping idols. So I will not allow you to sit in the bed of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam." And he looked at her, he said, problems in your mind, and he walk away. Subhanallah. Then he tried to choose any person, Ibn Abbas and Kada, to ask anything. Nobody helped him. Then Sufyan, Subhanallah, bin Harb, he found there is no way to do anything. He lost hope. Then Ibn Abbas, in that time after that, talked to him about Islam, and then he say, "أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله." Then he went to Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم and he declared الشهادة and he became a Muslim. Then Sufyan ibn Harb, after he became Muslim, and Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم already prepared the army to come to open Mecca. Then Ibn Abbas, he said, "Say something," because Sufyan ibn, he liked some status, because usually any king, any leader, any sultan, he liked to be praised. It's naturally, because a leader always, want to correct people, always to advise people. This is the character of the leader. So Nabi ﷺ told, "Whomever enter the house of Sufyan, fahuwa amin." Whomever enter the house of Sufyan, he will be in peace and nobody will harm him. Subhanallah. Then Sufyan ibn Harb, he returned back to Mecca, and subhanallah, he became Muslim and he declared Islam, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam opened Mecca, and the happiness come back to this family, that Ramla bint Abi Sufyan, her brother Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan become a Muslim, and her father become a Muslim, Sufyan bin Harb, and also her mother Hind become a Muslim, and alhamdulillah, Allah bless this family, which is one of the famous family from the family of the family of the tribes of Quraysh. Alhamdulillah. Ramla bint Abi Sufyan radiallahu an, she spent only 4 years with the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, three to four years radiallahu anha. Then suddenly the bad news came to her, that what happened, that her Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away and he went to the next life, and it was a big situation for and a calamity for Ramla bin Abi Sufyan radiallahu anha, when she loved the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam so much, and she learned from Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she learned a lot of ahadith. And Ramla bin Abi Sufyan, she narrate almost 65 hadith in the hadith from the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She become alima, she become a scholar of Islam, and she show as a great woman to her husband. She's a great woman to learn and seek the Islam, and she's a great woman although she is not the first wife, and she okay for her, for sake of Islam, for sake of La ilaha illallah, to remain with other Muslim sister under Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ummu Habiba radiyallahu anha, she narrates some of the hadith, and one of the hadith I would like to mention that Ummu Habiba, when her father passed away, Sufyan ibn Harb, after 3 days she called for the call al-asfar. Usually the woman, if they apply some nice smell, they call it, usually will be the color of that smell like a musk, yellow color. So the third day she applied, and he said, why you do this? She said, I hear Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I don't want to do, but I hear Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are not allowed to keep ourselves crying or something for anybody pass away more than 3 days, except our husband. Husband, the woman allowed to remain 4 months and 10 days. 4 months and 10 days for the husband only. But for the father and any one of her relative is not allowed to remain with the sad like a, what do you call it, she will not do anything. We call it the al-iddah, al-hidad. We call it in Arabic al-hidad. Hidad mean the woman, she will not decorate herself for a period of time if somebody pass away. We call it al-hidad. Hidad. And not from the sunnah, some people they wear black. It's not the sunnah, but what is meant that she doesn't have to put perfume, makeup, whatever. So this we call hidad. Ummu Habiba, she was very sincere to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she loved the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some of the hadith radiallahu anhu, Ummu Habiba, although as a, she is one of the wife of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but used to cooperate with her sister Azza bintu Abi Sufyan. فقد سمعت أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هم أن يتزوج درة بنت أم سلمة. فعن زينب بنت أبي سلمة أن أم حبيبة قالت قلت يا رسول الله انكح أختي بنت أبي سفيان. قال وتحبين؟ قلت نعم. قال لست لك بمحلية وأحب من شاركني في خير أختي. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن ذلك لا يحل له. Although that أم حبيبة هي one of the hadith, she is jealous, but she offered Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to marry her sister. Her sister named Azza. She said, Nabi Sallam, he surprised the offer of Ummu Habiba to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He asked, do you like that? She said, yes, I like. She can be helping me with any task. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he told her, إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَا يَحِلُّ لِي. Indeed, this is not lawful to me, that a person, he marry two sisters. SubhanAllah. قلت يا رسول الله إنا لنتحدث أنك تريد أن تنكح درة بنت أبي سلمة. قال بنت أبي أمي سلمة. فقلت نعم. قال فوالله لو لم تكن في حجري ما حلت لي، إنها لابنة أخي مي أنا الرضاعة أرضعتني وأبا سليمة ثويبية. Then he Nabi he asked her, she asked, how about درة بنت أمي سلمة؟ One lady, her name درة بنت أمي سلمة. قلت فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he said also is not lawful to me because أم سلمة she give breastfeeding to الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, so she is like a sister in رضاعة, ابنة أخي, the daughter of my brother, sorry, the daughter of my brother in from the breastfeeding, سبحان الله. So فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم then told them don't offer me anyone from your daughters or from your brothers, from your relative. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told her, and this is a hadith showing that she loved Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam so much, and she want the happiness of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and she want the goodness for the Ummah. Doesn't mind her jealousy, Subhanallah, that Ummu Habiba radiallahu anha, it's a unique woman, very unique. Also, Ummu Habiba radiallahu anha, she was very kind and good relationship with the other wives. And here, wallahi, very touching story. That before she died, Ummu Habiba radiallahu anha, she went all the way to Aisha. And she said, "Oh Aisha, I would like to ask, apologize and forgiveness from any issues happen in our life, between us, in any things, happen or not happen." Then Aisha, she said, "Ghafar Allahu laki wa anti hillun." Yani Allah forgive you and you are lawful, yani khalas, nothing between us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us. Then she said, "Wallahi innaki lasarartini," yani, "Oh Allah, by the name of Allah, you make me so much happy, and may Allah make you happy." And she went all the way to Ummu Salama, the other wife of Rasulullah sallam, and she said also the same. Subhanallah, look what the kindness, the softness, the akhlaq, the manners between the wife of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not that some people, they show them in the bad character. That's all, the one they not love Islam, they always try attack the wives of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they say the story unclear, they twist the meaning. Subhanallah. After that, Ummu Habiba radiyallahu anha, she died in the time of 44 from the Hijrah, the year of 44, and she buried in Al-Baqi', and she was in that time, she was 72 years old radiallahu anha, in the Khilafat of Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan, her brother radiallahu anha wa ardaha. So this is some of the story showing la ilaha illallah, this woman, she faced so much difficulty and she was sabira. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was showing to us amazing story for this woman radiallahu anha, Ramla bintu Abi Sufyan. Let me stop for a moment. What we can learn from this story? Who can tell us from this story some is beneficial things? First of all, we can say الصبر مفتاح الفرج. What is mean this? Patience, it's the key of all the opening and solving all the matter. وما أعطي أحد عطاء مثل الصبر. There is no gift better than the gift and hadiyah of the صبر. Look, this, she was sabira lillah. Allah gave her the best person, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Also, we learn, for sake of Allah, you do whatever things can do. Our life, our soul is cheap for la ilaha illallah. She is handle strange country, strange life. She migrate two migration. Migration of Hijrah, of to Abyssinia, and migration of to Al-Madina, radiallahu anha. Also, we learn from some of the beautiful story, the love for the Muslims, brothers and sisters. It doesn't make her like hate the other wives of Rasulullah sallam. She liked them and she cooperate with them. And she was very great akhlaq with them. And she went and she asked Aisha forgiveness. And she went all the way and asked Umm Salama forgiveness. And she was considered those darayr. Darayr mean the sharing one husband. And she kept her high status. I will not involve all talking and issues and problems. I keep myself high person. Ramla bint Abi Sufyan radhiyallahu anha. Also, we learn the aqidah, the tawheed, al-wala'i wal-bara'. And this is very important. Al-wala'i wal-bara', that my heart belongs to Islam. My soul belongs to Islam. My heart belongs to the Muslims. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. I see some situation nowadays that some Muslims, they happy that what happened in the Muslims in Gaza and they are supporting Israel and they are Muslims. They say those group, bad group. Astaghfirullah, you supporting the kuffar over the Muslims, although you disagree with the, some of the things. This is how the Billah, where is the wala al-bara? Where is the tawheed? Where is the iman, the love for the love the Muslims more than non-Muslim, the one that not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How come you love the one does not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah, and love them more than loving the one they declare La ilaha Muhammad Rasulullah? And I realize that sometimes, like some Muslims, they owe more, you know, running with the tail of the kuffar, and when the other Muslims talking to them, they ignoring them. They have a doubtful on their tawheed and aqeedah. You can be kind and good for the kuffar, the one they not doing, they are not the enemy to Islam. But the one they open the openly to be as an enemy of Islam, killing the Muslims, how come you love them and support them? So look, her father Sufyan ibn Harb and her husband, they are both fighting Nabi and the leader of Kuffar of Quraysh, they fighting, but her heart belonged to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when her father come, he went to sit down, only sit down, she took away the mattress and she took away the bed and she said, this is the bed of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam and you are unclean, unpure, you are najis, you are mushrik, you worshipping idols. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, it's amazing. And maybe you don't realize the feeling. This is in Arabic culture, is very shameful. Shameful. And that time they follow the culture of tribism. If a lady do this, all the tribe will be enemy. Not one person. If one person, okay, the father, all right. But all the tribes of Bani Umayyah, thousands of people, they will attack in here. But she doesn't care. Tawheed, my iman, my faith, Allah, la ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. Allahu Akbar. So this is some of the lessons we learn from this moment. As I said in the beginning, wallahi, I read the story, I put my head down as a man. Where is the iman of this woman, la ilaha illallah, compared to the sahabiya radiallahu anha? She did something wallahi man cannot do. Radiallahu anha wa ardaha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with ummahat al-mu'mineen, the mothers of the believer, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise them in the Quran. Wa azwajuhu ummahatuhum, and the wives of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were the mothers of the believers. Jazakum Allah khayran wa ahsanu Allah ilaykum. May Allah reward you, may Allah give us the iman and make us understand the right information and follow the Islam in the right way. Jazakum Allah khair wa ahsan Allah ilaykum. If you have any question, inshallah, you would like to ask, share. Jazakum Allah khair wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam taslima kathir.